I found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in. Follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. Just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. But darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, you're holding mine. Between my arms, barefoot on the grass, we're listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it. Darling, you look perfect tonight. Well, I found a woman stronger than anyone I know. She shares my dreams. I hope that someday I'll share her home. I found a love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own.
We are gathered together today on this day to witness and celebrate the love of Kris and Kate. We are not here to mark the start of a relationship, but to acknowledge and strengthen a bond that already exists. Many of you were in attendance in September when Kris and Kate first shared their vows. They formally said, "I do," on their second anniversary in a traditional Catholic ceremony where their love was blessed and acknowledged by their faith. Today, they will once again affirm their love for one another, but in their own way. As their dearest family and friends, it is our honor and privilege to stand witness to this event.
Kris, when we met, my life changed in ways I never could have imagined. Everyone always searches for the butterflies, but on our first date, my heart finally felt at peace. For the first time, I felt this steadiness, this contentment that I had never experienced before. It was as if my heart and mind had found some missing piece that had been missing for far too long. I feel so incredibly lucky and blessed to be standing here with you today, choosing forever to share our hopes and dreams, the ups and downs, and everything in between. You are my person. Kris, I promise to always stand by your side as we stand today with love and respect for you during all the big and small moments in life. I promise to always be open to new experiences because our adventures together are my favorite. I promise to be the ear to listen when you need to talk, or to be your warmth and hug when you're not ready to. I promise to motivate and support you, to help you achieve all your dreams. I promise to be your rock and biggest fan in those moments of doubt and hesitation. I will always be sure of you and all you're capable of. I promise to always hold your hand because together I know we can get through anything. I promise to not always take life too seriously and to always try to make you smile because I think your smile is the best in the world. I promise to always put you, our love, our marriage first, regardless of where life takes us. If we are blessed with a family, I promise to continue to put you first, knowing that a foundation is always the most important part of anything built, and our love will always be our foundation. I promise to love your family as I love my own. They are your roots and have helped to shape you into the person you are today. Most importantly, I promise to always show you how much I appreciate you for everything you do and everything you are. I don't know how I got so lucky to have you as my best friend and partner in life, but without a doubt, it truly is a better place since you came along. Kris, you are my today and all of my tomorrows. I will always choose you.
I am wired, apparently. Does this mic work?
I don't know.
Okay. Kate.
That is my name.
That is your name.
You got it right.
You are a kind, compassionate, patient, articulate, and beautiful woman that has made me feel more loved than I ever thought possible. You inspire me to be the best version of myself. Your support is undoubtedly the backbone of my achievements. I am grateful to be standing here in front of you as we share this moment and start new adventures. Today, I vow to take you as my only love, to carry the warmth of our love over years through difficult times, up hills and over oceans. I promise to be faithful and love you unconditionally every day for the rest of our lives. I promise to put us and the family we create above all else. I promise to keep the house stocked with wine after stressful workful days. I will always be your best friend, your confidant, your ally in conflict, your greatest fan, and your accomplice in mischief. My heart has truly been in a better place since you came along.
Stop.
On your wedding day, you exchanged rings as a symbol of the never-ending circle of love. Rings serve as a reminder of your wedding vows to each other and your commitment to live in unity, love, and happiness. At this time, it is appropriate to reconfirm the meaning of the rings you wear. Please join your left hands together so that Kris's hand is on the top. Kris, please repeat after me. Kate, I wear this ring.
Kate, I wear this ring.
You placed on my hand.
You placed on my hand.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And commitment to you.
And commitment to you.
Now, with Kate's hand on top, Kate, please repeat after me. Kris, I wear this ring.
Kris, I wear this ring.
You placed on my hand.
You placed on my hand.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And commitment to you.
And commitment to you.
So, by joining hands right now and looking into each other's eyes, let it be known that you are joined inseparably in this lifetime and that this bond continues. I ask that you each remember to continue to cherish each other as special and unique individuals, and that you each respect the thoughts and ideas of one another. And most of all, be able to forgive each other and not hold grudges against one another. Live each day in love with each other, always being there to give compassion, comfort, refuge to each other in good times and bad. Kris and Kate, today you have renewed the promises and vows you made to each other on your wedding day. You have symbolized the renewal of the marriage union, by the joining of hands, the taking of vows, and the wearing of your wedding rings. It is with pleasure that I conclude this ceremony of renewing the vows of marriage that join you and bind you as husband and wife. Please celebrate this renewal of vows with a kiss.
Yeah. Good?
Can we go?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Yeah. There's also the music.
There it is. You good?
Well, parents, please come to the center of the dance floor. And this is a long cherished Polish tradition which has been passed down through the centuries. It symbolizes the union of the bride and groom. So the bride and groom right now are being greeted by their parents with bread and salt and a glass of wine. The parents sprinkle the bread with salt and give it to both of the newlyweds to eat. The bread represents the parents' hope that their children will never experience hunger or need. The salt reminds the couple that their life may be difficult at times, and they must learn together to cope with life's struggles. The parents now present a glass of wine to the bride and groom for each of them to drink. With the wine, the parents hope that they will never thirst, and they will have a life of good health and cheer, and share the company of many good friends. The parents now join in kissing the bride and groom as a welcome to the family and a sign of their love and unity. Big round of applause out there, guys. Let them hear it.
These are the thoughts of a father on the wedding day of his daughter. As his mind wanders back to the first time he held her, he looks at her now, the same pride in his eyes, as onto the dance floor they glide. This is the dance of the bride and her father. Dance with me, daughter of mine, on this your wedding day. Dance with me, daughter of mine, you'll soon be going away. I loved you since you first began, now you've found a new man. But I love you so, and this you must know, that my love won't falter. So dance with me, daughter, beautiful daughter, daughter of mine. We walk down the
aisle. I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything,
everyone. First, I would like to thank you all for coming to celebrate Kate and Kris. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Kate's sister, Christina. Okay. Being 9 years older than Kate, I have had the privilege to watch Kate grow into the amazing and beautiful woman she has become every step of the way. When Kate was born, she became my best friend, and I did everything with her. She loved Big Bird, and to this day, her favorite color is yellow. We watched countless hours of Barney, and I thank Kate for knowing every word and song to The Little Mermaid. Of course, it's not to say as we got older, I didn't torture her a little bit. One Christmas, I had her convinced her present under the tree was just copy paper wrapped up, but it was actually the Little Mermaid sheets that she had wanted. She always wanted to hang out with me and my friends, so I would... I would tell Kate to go to her room, count to 50, and then I'd let her in. Of course, I had her do it 4 or 5 times before I actually did. I was actually lucky enough to teach Kate how to drive, and somehow we're still here. Then Kate went to college and earned her degrees and started her career, and here we are today. Oh my God, I'm shaking. I remember the first time I heard about Kris. It was my birthday. My parents were in Germany, so Kate, Ray, and Sarah surprised me. I came home, and there was a picture of my parents on the dining room table so that they were all there for my birthday. So when we were done, I said, "What are you doing tonight?" And she said, "I'm going out with this guy, Kris." I said, "Really?" I said, "Where'd you meet him?" She said, "Oh, my friend from high school messaged me and asked me if I wanted to get set up with his brother-in-law." Thank you, Chadwick. And the rest is history. I remember the first time I met Kris at my parents' house. I don't remember what we were there for, but I knew from the minute I met him, I considered him family. And when I left, I thought to myself, yep, he's the one. Kris has such a great personality and sense of humor. Kate and Kris bring out the best in each other. They light up a room when they walk in it. They literally are the perfect couple. Kris, I want to thank you for being so good to my sister and making her smile in a way that I have never seen before. To see her so happy really warms my heart. You are an amazing person, and I'm proud to call you my brother-in-law, especially my family. Now, if we can all raise our glasses, congratulations to Kate and Kris, and a lifetime of love and laughter. Slánce, stolat na zdrowie, cheers.
Thank you. I have a lot less to say. What? I have a lot less to say. I don't know Kris as long as Kate and Christina know each other. So just like Christina mentioned in the beginning of her speech, I wanted to also thank everyone on behalf of the bride and groom for attending such a special ceremony and being part of this wonderful day. It's gonna go down in history. This is one of those days you'll never remember. So we have a few folks here, like the Stroinovskis, who only live 15 minutes away. Aren't we all jealous? Nobody's got a 15-minute commute to the barn. We also have Kris's aunt. She's a 9-hour flight away from Poland. Aren't we all jealous? She's here with us as well. I'm going to say all of that in Polish right now. Chciałbym wszystkim podziękować za to, że jesteście razem z nami i spędzacie tę niedzielę z nami, żeby z Krzysiem i z Kate spędzić ten bardzo ważny dzień w ich życiu, którego nigdy nie zapamiętają. A więc tak jak mówiłem, są tutaj Strojnoscy, którzy mieszkają tylko 15 minut stąd i też jest ciocia Wiola, która przyleciała 9 godzin. Bardzo ci dziękujemy za to, że jesteś tutaj razem z nami. To jest dla nas niesamowite i dziękujemy ci jeszcze raz. On that same note, I'm going to switch languages back and forth. This is going to be fun. No, I won't. So from now on, I'll just stick to English. I wanted to thank Sean and Helen Keaveney for raising such a smart, beautiful, thank you, Helen, and fun, thank you, Sean, daughter. And I wanted to thank Andrzej and Anna Dzitkowski for raising this stud. And I want to tell you a little bit about this stud. actually, I'm going to let other people tell you about this stud, because what Christina told me is that you're really funny, and you just make her laugh all the time. And Emma, Chris's goddaughter, proudly announces to everyone she meets that here comes my godfather. Most importantly, she loves playing Ozma with him, which is a coding game that only Chris has patience for. Mr. Keaveney told me that Chris did the most honorable thing, which was to come to him and ask for Kate's hand in marriage. Meant the world to him. He says he treats my daughter well, and he knows that she's his wife first, but my princess. His godmother told me that Chris has the warmest of souls, and that's something that's never changed. He's always happy and smiling. And most importantly, you all know that the real reason I'm here is because I'm Chris's brother-in-law. Shit. Who am I? Got lost in my own words. I'm married to Chris's sister, and so I've spent a lot of time with her, and she told me that while growing up, she never felt like she was alone. Like there was always someone that had her back. She said, you know, there's a lot of kids that were raised and they were always one or the other fighting against the parents. But for us, it was always us. And that's important. She goes, it was always Chris and I against the world. And she's very happy for that.
Okay, Jeff.
So I know that your love will grow for the both of you to be even more beautiful in 5 and 10, 20 and 40 years from now. And each year will teach you the meaning of love. And that love will grow even deeper and deeper. And I know that your love will be an example to the world that may have forgotten what love really is. And that the children that you will bring into this world one day will come to know a father that's a leader, and will get to know a mother's tenderness, and how close God is to both of you. And with that, here's to you. Meet the Jitkovskis. Everyone, na zdrovje.
Please, me, don't even have to try.